Добро вечер, почитувани гледачи, вечерашното ТВ интервју е посветено на една тема која е во медиумите број 1, која овие денови го потресува Балканот, старата дама Европа и целиот финансиски свет. Погодувате станува збор за кризата финансиска што потресува Грција, нашиот јужен сосед, а што ќе донесе она што беше референдум таму и што ќе донесат деновите и месеците што доаѓаат. Вечерва разговарам со мојот и ваш познаник, аналитичарот Сен Вакнин. Добро вечер, господин Сен Вакнин.
Добро вечер, ви благодарам на поканата.
Моето прво прашање до вас гласи. Ова е една од многуте финансиски кризи во Грција. Во што е прво незината генеза, а потоа, ако може да објасните, што значи она реченица должен како Грција?
The crisis is comprised of three elements, three components. One, the insolvency of the Greek state. The Greek state has to pay every month 2.2 billion euros in pensions and wages to the public sector. In addition to payment of interest on debts, in addition to payment for infrastructure, in addition. They don't have this money because tax collection has gone down. The economy of Greece collapsed by 26% in the last 5 years. So the collection of taxes went down. They don't have enough taxes, they don't have enough money. They don't have enough money, they cannot pay. So this is problem, crisis number one. And this is an internal crisis in Greece. Second crisis is a banking crisis. The banks of Greece are running out of money. Until now, they received a lot of money from the European Central Bank through the National Bank of Greece. But now the European Central Bank refuses to continue to give money and even insists that the Greek banks give additional collateral to the European Central Bank. So very shortly, in a matter of 2-3 days, the Greek banks will be completely out of money, out of cash. You will go to the ATM and nothing will come out. Mm-hmm. That's the second crisis. And the third crisis is a crisis of debt, loans, credits, that the country of Greece has taken over many decades. It didn't start today. Greece has actually defaulted in 2010, again in 2012, again in 2014, and again this year it did not pay to the IMF on the 30th of June. So there is a general problem of debt. The debt is divided into three parts. There is a debt to international organizations such as the IMF, International Monetary Fund, the ECB, the World Bank, the ECB, the European Central Bank, and other bodies and organizations. Second part of the debt is money that Greece owes directly to other nations, to other countries. For instance, Greece owes more than 30 billion euros to Spain. Greece owes money to Portugal, to Spain, to United Kingdom, to Germany, directly, country to country. And the third part, which is not a small part, it's about 80 billion euros, is money that the Greeks took from private investors, from pension funds, mm-hmm. from commercial banks. They have to pay back. On the 10th of July, the end of this week, on Friday, they have to pay 2 billion euros to people who bought bonds from the Greek government, and they don't have the money.
Дали може да ни кажете колков е вкупниот износ на грчкиот долг што треба да биде исплатен до крајот на оваа календарска 2015 година?
Yes, Greece owes in total 340 billion, which is 180% of its economy, almost twice its economy. Out of this, it owes 232 billion euros to the Euro group, the countries, the banks, everywhere, everything. This month, it has to pay about 6 billion euros, this month, this July. Next month, another 6 billion euros. And until the end of the year, a total of 30 billion euros. So Greece, just to pay the debts and be able to survive, needs 29 billion euros in cash immediately and another 23 billion before the end of the year. Otherwise, if they don't get 56 billion euros, or 50 billion according to the IMF, the Greeks will go bankrupt. Even if they get some money, they need this huge amount, or they will go bankrupt.
Да се подсетиме дека на последните парламентарни избори во Грција победи левичарското движење Сириза, начело со Алексис Ципрас. Тој во неговата предизборна кампања се сврте против штедењето, потоа да се дадат поголеми даноци за богатите луѓе. Но со оваа предизборна програма тој предизвика, така да кажам, едно вознемирување кај меѓународните кредитори. Европската Централна банка веднаш после изборите кога Ципрас ја презеде власта порача дека таа веќе не може да учествува во алиментирањето на грчкиот долг. Дали ова беше првиот аларм во светските финансиски кругови за палење на црвеното светло, на звонење на сите звона дека можно е колапс на целиот финансиски систем во светот?
No, I don't think it will come to the collapse of the... You must understand that Greece is a very small country. Greece is 1.7% of the economy of Europe. It is nothing. Even if Greece disappears tomorrow, no one will notice. The problem is not Greece as an economy. The problem is the euro. Greece is a member of the euro. Greece is using the euro as a currency. If Greece leaves the euro, then other members of the euro, such as Spain, Portugal and even Italy, which is a giant country, will be under pressure from international investors. Because international investors will say, if Greece leaves the euro and is paying now drachmas instead of euros, I don't want to invest any more money in Spain, in Portugal, in Italy. Tomorrow, Spain, Portugal and Italy will leave the euro and they will pay me instead of euros, they will pay me as an investor, they will pay me pesetas. I don't want pesetas, I want euros. So the problem is the euros. Now, the Syriza coalition is not only left-wing. Actually, one of the components of the coalition is very right-wing. It is the Independent Greeks. Independent Greeks party is right-wing. But it is true that the dominant figures in the coalition are all ex-communists, current communists, and Marxists. So we have, for instance, Varoufakis, ex-Minister of Finance, was a Marxist. The current Minister of Finance, the new one, is still a member of the Communist Party. He's a communist. So they regard capitalism in general as a very vicious and evil system that they must fight on behalf of the people. Having said that, the differences between Greece and the EU are not as big as the international media is saying and not as big as the EU is saying. There are exactly three differences between Greece and the EU. Difference number one, Greece wants to begin to reduce pensions for rich people starting next year, and the EU wants them to reduce pension to wealthy people, to rich people, this year. Second thing, Greece agrees. Today, Greece has six levels of VAT, DDV, six levels. Greece agrees to make it three levels instead of six, but Greece insists that the islands will not pay VAT. The islands have a reduced level of VAT because the islands are far and they have to pay transportation and so on, and they say that if they have to pay VAT, the tourists will not come. So Greece insists that the islands will not pay VAT. That is the second problem. And the third problem, Greece insists that the EU will delete part of the debt, not restructure, not reprogram, not spread the debt over a long period of time, not reduce the interest rate, but delete completely. Greece wants about 30 to 50% of the debt to the EU, total of 100 to 150 billion, to be deleted, like never existed.
Во светската ранг листа на најзадолжените земји, Грција, според некои податоци, е на 27-то место. Прва е Америка, втора е Британија, трета е Франција, четврта е Германија. Зошто таму не избиваат финансиски кризи, туку токму во Грција? Има ли тука некоја скриена игра?
Two reasons, I think. First of all, Greece doesn't have an economy. The export sector of Greece, export sector, is 13% of GDP. In Germany, the export sector is 70% of GDP, 70. So Greece doesn't have economy. The whole economy of Greece is composed of tourism, retail, small shops. These small shops are actually selling to tourists. So it's again tourism. And the government. Greece is manufacturing nothing, selling nothing, exporting nothing, and doesn't have an economy. And that's the difference between Greece and Germany, or Greece and the United States. Mm-hmm. Second, equally important thing, is that the countries you have mentioned, except Germany, can print their own currency. If the United States owes you money, it's not a problem. They will print dollars, and they will give you dollars. If the United Kingdom owes you money, they will print British pounds. They will give you British pounds. Greece cannot print money. Greece cannot print euros.
Што е разликата што Америка и Британија можат да печатат пари, а Грција не може?
They can simply print the money that they owe you. Simple. Greece owes you money, but cannot print euros. They need to get the euros from the ECB. They need to get the euros from other sources. In other words, Greece does not control its monetary policy. Greece does not control its currency policy. If Greece, for instance, wants tomorrow to print a currency and to pay you, and it will have inflation as a result, they cannot do it because they are into the Euro club.
Да се вратиме на референдумот што беше одржан на 6-ти овој месец, грците рекоа во големо мнозинство не на условите што ги поставија кредиторите.
Охи.
Охи. Но што по ваквиот резултат на овој референдум? Кои се вашите прогнози? Како ќе се развива целата ситуација?
Again, I think the international media is confusing politics with economics. The referendum was an internal political game of Tsipras. Tsipras needed to prove to his opponents, to the opposition and to the international community, he needed to prove that he is very popular, that he is supported, that what he says, he has behind him the Greek people. So he did the referendum in order to prove to everyone that he is representing the Greek people, because the EU was saying that he is not. The opposition was saying that most of the people wanted the euro, most of the people wanted the EU, and that Tsipras was not representing the people. So he said, you know what, I will show you that I am representing the people. And he made the referendum. Referendum has no economic implications, no economic effects and results whatsoever. It is totally internal Greek affair. The negotiations with the EU started long before the referendum and will continue this week after the referendum. The referendum only means that Tsipras will be much less flexible in his demands from the EU. He will insist to cut the debt, he will insist to reschedule, he will insist to get 56 billion euros, 29 now, 23, 27 later. He will now insist not to cut the pensions, he will insist not to cut the VAT to the islands, and he will feel that the Greek people is behind him. If, as a result, there will be Grexit, if Greek will leave the euro, if as a result there will be bankruptcy, if the banks will be nationalized, collapse and then be nationalized, he can always say, it's not my fault. The Greek people voted in the referendum. I only did what they told me to do. So he has insurance. It was an insurance policy. Mm-hmm. Because he knows very well that he is pushing Greece to leave the euro. He is pushing for the banks to be nationalized. And he is pushing to establish a quasi-socialist economy in Greece. He has a clear agenda where he's going. I don't think Tsipras will be too disappointed if the result on Monday is that the banks are nationalized and the result after that is that there's no euro.
Но да потсетам дека Варуфакис, што го спомнавте, марксистот, комунистот, односно, во неговата оставка рече дека она што беше речено не на референдумот, значеше величествено големо да за демократска и рационална Европа. Дали се согласувате со тој негов став?
Look, Greece, it is not true to say that Greece did not try. Mm-hmm. Greece, in the last 5 years, made huge efforts to try to comply with the conditions of the Eurogroup, of the IMF and the ECB. They tried. For example, a year ago or 2 years ago, the budget deficit of Greece was 10%. After that, 8% of gross domestic product, 10% of the economy. After that, 8% of the economy. Then last year, Greece had budget surplus, not deficit. They moved from minus 10 to plus 1.5. That is a huge movement, enormous movement. They fired 30,000 people in the public administration. They cut the pensions. by one third. So they were trying. But Greece society is so corrupt, so politicized. Greek mentality is so socialized. In other words, the state owes me. The state should take care of me. Mm-hmm. Greece economy is so primitive, so non-existent, that even with the best intentions, it was difficult. But there are other countries who were exactly the same condition like Greece in Europe. Spain, Portugal, Ireland, Iceland. These countries adopted the measures of the EU, of the Eurogroup, adopted the measures of the IMF, accepted the conditions of the ECB, implemented a very tough program. Latvia, Estonia in 2008. I can give you a name, 20 countries, you know. Slovakia. All of them implemented these measures. In Latvia, they cut the public administration, they cut the government by 35% in 1 year. So, and after 5 years, all of them, except maybe Spain, are in very good shape. The economy is flourishing, everything is working, full employment.
Сега се префрливе малку на атмосферата во Брисел, односно после овие бурни настани со референдумот и одгласите негови, во Брисел, во Европската Унија се запалија некои аларми. Ангела Меркел веднаш отиде во Париз на консултации со Оланд и од тој состанок излезе едно сообщение во кое што можам да го сублимирам во две реченици. Дека е постигната согласност ЕУ да биде солидарна, а Грција да биде одговорна. Како ги коментирате овие термини?
If we want to concentrate on politicians, we will not go far. You can never understand what they want, what they mean, and the worst part, they don't understand what they want. So it will not take us far. Here are some tough, hard facts. The Greek economy is not a good type of economy. It is not producing, it is not selling, it is not exporting. The Greek worker is a very bad worker. The productivity of the Greek worker is one half the average of the European Union. Mm-hmm. But the Greek worker is getting paid more than 60% of the countries of the European Union. So it's getting paid a lot of money, but producing much less. The Greek banks are undercapitalized. The Greeks don't have foreign exchange reserves. Greece has foreign exchange reserves twice as Macedonia. Macedonia has 1.6 billion. Greece has 2.9 billion. Macedonia has almost 60% of the foreign exchange reserves of Greece. Can you imagine? So it's not a problem of solidarity or democracy or all the other, you know, nonsense that politicians keep mentioning all the time. It's a problem that Greece cannot function as it is currently. It cannot pay back the debt, so the debt has to be eliminated. It cannot continue as it is. It has to cut pensions, it has to cut public administration, and so on and so forth. The reform needs to be very fundamental. This is what Tsipras refuses to accept. Tsipras keeps submitting proposals over the last 4 months. Each one of them is cosmetic proposal. Okay, I will change this a little, I will do this. It's not a little change. You need nuclear bomb in Greece. To change the economy from the foundations.
Вашите коментари, односно констатации за менталитетот на грците, за потенцијалите на нивната економија, за банкарскиот сектор, ме збунуваат. Зошто тогаш Европа ја држи Грција во своите рамки и не дава она што се нарекува хирушки рез да рече доста е веќе, не може вака и така натаму.
The European Union, based on false data, false information provided by Greece, the false information, Greece hired international financial experts like Goldman Sachs, and they falsified the economic information of Greece. Based on the false economic information, Greece was accepted into the euro. The problem is that once Greece was accepted into the euro, it would be very difficult to cut and let it go out of the euro. Mm-hmm. As I explained before, imagine that I'm an investor and I bought bonds from Greece, obveznici, government bonds from Greece. When I bought the bonds, Greece promised to pay me back with euros. Now Greece is leaving the euro and will pay me with drachmas. What can I do with the drachmas? I don't want drachma, I want euro. I bought a euro. So if Greece leaves the euro, all the investors, all the banks, or everyone will be paid with drachmas. So this is big trauma. After that, I will say, I don't want to give money to Spain. I don't want to give money to Portugal. I don't want to give money to Italy, because tomorrow they will also leave the euro. And if they leave the euro, they will pay me Italian lira, mm-hmm. peseta.
Сега ова што го говорите, ќе ве подсетам на еден извештај на New York Times овие денови, кој напиша, ако сега Европа не ја казни Грција, тогаш ќе им даде многу лош пример за другите, односно ќе мора на ист начин да го реши проблемот со долговите на Италија, Шпанија, Португалија. Ако пак Европа не ги примени тие мерки, New York Times вели дека Европската унија ќе се распадне.
No, no. People are confusing European Union with the Eurozone, Eurogroup. The euro is the currency of 19 nations out of 28 in the European Union. So the European Union is not connected to the euro. There are many countries in the European Union that are not using the euro, like Poland, like so. It is a crisis of the Eurozone, not of the European Union. The European Union is not at risk. The Eurozone is at a minimal risk. The risk, again, is that if Greece leaves the euro, other countries will be under pressure from investors. Mm-hmm. They will not be able to sell their own bonds. They will not be able to raise money. They will not be able to pay salaries. Their own banks will collapse. This is the risk. There is no other risk. So the solution is there are two solutions. Solution number one, to allow Greece to print its own drachma, but to keep the euro. So Greece will be a member of the euro. Dada, it's called parallel currency. Mm-hmm. Greece will, to the outside, Greece will pay with euro. It will pay the bonds with euro. It will pay for imports with euro. It will buy oil with euro. It will buy food with euro. It will pay the ECB with euro. It will pay the IMF with euro. Everything outside will be with euro. Everything inside will be with drachma. Pensioners will get drachma, government workers will get drachma, in the street you will buy with drachma, sell with drachma, everything inside will be drachma. This mechanism is known as parallel currency, and it's done. Second solution is for the ECB to say, Greece will be out of the euro, Grexit, and from that moment, we, the ECB, guarantee the debts of Spain, Portugal, Italy, Ireland. From that moment, it will be actually the debt of Germany. So if they do that, it will become the debt of Germany, and there will be no risk for these countries. There is no third solution.
Дали мислите дека Грција е единствен виновник за оваа криза што ја мачи сега неа, или има и други некои странични фактори што ја предизвикувале таа криза?
They are definitely not the only guilty. Definitely. First of all,
кои се другите?
Banks, European banks, that gave money and gave money and gave money and gave loans and gave credits without any consideration, without checking the books, without bothering to, because they believed that Greece is guaranteed by the ECB, by the euro. It's in the euro, so it's a problem of Germany. If there will be a problem, Germany will pay, which actually happened. Actually happened. Do you know that all the money that Greece received from the euro group, all of it, was used to pay back the banks? The European banks, Greece didn't take 1 euro from all the money, this 232 billion euros. Greece didn't take 1 euro. All of it went in, out, back to the European banks. Mm-hmm. And now the European banks, Greece owes to the European banks 2 billion, when at the beginning it was more than 100 billion. So the European banks, then the international financial companies that helped Greece falsify the books, mm-hmm. Many guilty parties, many guilty.
Денес прочитав на интернет некои вести што се доста индикативни. Имено прочитав дека Кина веќе купува некои грчки острови, има дадено понуда за купување на Пирејското пристаниште и така натаму. Дали продажбата на островите, пристаништата и другите инфраструктурни објекти се еден од начините за Грција да се извади од оваа калво која што е западната?
Greek had until now two major bailouts, bailout programs. Bailout means that the Europeans gave Greece money to survive. So one of the conditions was that Greece will sell state-owned companies, will sell shares in banks that it owned. The Greek state will sell shares in banks, will sell islands, and will sell infrastructure projects such as the Piraeus harbor, port, and railroads for trains and so on. Greece agreed in 2012 to sell assets for 50 billion euros. They said, we will sell Piraeus, we will sell this, we'll sell together 50 billion. Until today, the Greeks sold 2.8 billion. Instead of 50, they sold 2.8. Not only they did not sell, but they bought back. The Greek state bought back some companies. Example, the national broadcaster. Mm-hmm. The national broadcasting television of Greece was closed, and then a few months ago was opened again.
Yeah.
They started it again. So not only they did not sell Piraeus port and the islands and the train and the, not only they did not sell, not only they did not get 50 billion that they should have paid to the creditors, but they sold 2.8 billion only, and they used some of the money that the Europeans gave them to buy back companies that used to be owned by the state, again to buy them back to be state owned. So they are not serious about privatization. The Greeks say they don't want to sell anything now because the price would be very low. They say now it's panic.
Yes,
they say now the prices are low. But this is now. In 2010, the price for Piraeus port was not low. They don't want to sell. They don't want to sell because they employ their relatives, their family, their friends,
no.
Party, people from the party, political parties, and so on.
Сега да се префрлиме на односите со соседите. Имено, Грција е, така речи, најголем економски инвеститор во Македонија. Да спомнеме рафинеријата Окта, цементарница Усје, Веропулос, Стопанска банка и така натаму. Со какви ефекти ќе се рефлектира таа криза што моментално буи во Грција во однос на македонската економија и воопшто на Македонија?
Depends what will happen to Greece. If Greece receives another bailout package, if the Greek banks survive somehow, or even if they are nationalized and survive, in other words, if Greece avoids bankruptcy, official bankruptcy, then I think the effect will be minimal, almost nothing. If, however, the Greek state will become officially bankrupt, then creditors of Greece, people, individuals, banks, pension funds, other countries that gave money to Greece, they have a right by international law to take assets of Greece outside Greece.
Mm-hmm.
Greek companies and the Greek state have some assets in Macedonia, and these assets may become subject to international litigation in international courts between the creditors to which Greece owes money, and the Greek state. So Macedonia can find itself suddenly involved in court proceedings between individual investors, banks, other countries like Spain and Portugal suing Greece, and Greece in the middle of the fire between these two. And these creditors will try to take Greek assets in Macedonia as payment. Instead of the money that Greece owes them, they will try to take Stopanska Banka or some other asset.
Mm-hmm.
It will not be easy. It will not be easy, but it could create some problems. Other than that, I don't think there will be a major problem in the financial system. And I trust the Macedonian banks much more than I trust, of course, the Greek banks or even many other European banks.
Mm-hmm.
Macedonian banks are pretty stable and well financed.
Кога ги спомнате македонските банки, да го цитирам гувернерот на Народната банка на Македонија Димитар Богов, кој изјави дека домашните банки со доминантен странски капитал се заштитени и сигурни, но сепак според вас, колку се сигурни штедните влогови на граѓаните од Македонија кои се депонирани во банките што се со претежно грчки капитал? Може ли некој ризик тука?
No, there is no risk to people with deposits in these banks. The banks can change ownership. Maybe today they are Greek, and tomorrow some creditor will take over, and so they will become suddenly Spanish banks or Portuguese banks or whatever. So ownership can change somehow. But I don't think there's any risk to deposits and so on. However, some countries are very exposed to Greek debt. They're in danger because of the Greek debt. For example, Slovenia. 3% of the Slovenian economy is invested in Greece. Greece owes to Slovenia money that is equal to 3% of the economy of Slovenia. So there we have a question about NLB Tutunska Banka. We have a question about Stopanska Banka, because directly or indirectly there is government, Greek government involvement. We have a question about other assets of Greece here, because the Greek state, the Greek government is involved in all the business in Greece. You can't say, oh, this is totally private. There is nothing totally private in Greece. Always you will find some involvement of the state. And if the Greek country, if the Greek state goes bankrupt, it will have legal effect on assets in Macedonia. However, the effect will not be on the level of deposit holders, not be on the level of you and me. Mm-hmm. It will be on the level of who will own the bank, who will own the OKTA, who will own, you know, who will own the assets, така. Ownership.
Сега да се префрлиме пак малку на теренот на Европа, денови беше актуелно нешто што прострои по интернет дека французидот Тома Пикети, автор на книгата Капиталот во 21-виот век, во интервју за Цајт, германскиот вестник, вели дека е повеќе од необходно во Европа да се одржи една обшта европска конференција за проблемите на финансиската презадолженост. Затоа што конзервативните мерки на европските политичари се закануваат со деструкција на Европската Унија. Се согласувате со овој французин?
It's Thomas Piketty.
Thomas Piketty.
Piketty, and gave the interview to Die Zeit, yes. I do not think that the debt situation in Europe justifies a debt conference. What he's suggesting is called debt conference. It's a conference of all the countries, and they agree, let's say, to delete 60% of the debt, 70% of the debt, to say, okay, we cancel the debt. From now on, everyone owes 30% what they used to owe before the conference. I don't think it's reached this level. Actually, the situation today is far better than it was 3 years ago. 3 years ago, it was very dangerous. Today, the situation is much better for the simple reason that the ECB is in charge of printing euros. And it is printing 1 to 2 trillion euros a year. That means 1,000 to 2,000 billion miliardi euros every year, and putting this money into the economy. This is called quantitative easing. Mm-hmm. The Federal Reserve did this in the United States and saved the economy. The British, the National Bank of Britain did it in Britain and saved the British economy. There is no reason to assume that the ECB will not be able to save the European economy. Of the 12 countries that were in difficulties in the year, between the year 2008 and 2012, there were 12 countries in difficulties, including the Baltic states, Estonia, Latvia, including Ireland, including Spain, including Portugal, Italy, and so on. Of these 12 countries, today, essentially, there are only two countries that are still in some difficulty, that is, except Greece. That is Spain, which is in a big difficulty, and to some extent Portugal, which is not really in a big difficulty. Mm-hmm. All the other countries have a growing economies, repaid most of their debts, and are in excellent shape. An example is Ireland. Ireland is in excellent shape. Iceland is in excellent shape. Latvia, Estonia, they're all with huge growing economies in excellent shape. So I don't see any reason for...
Да, но денове видов едно отворено писмо на естонците до грците, им велат дека да ќе ви помогнеме, но дайте вие имате 2000 евра пензија, а ние имаме 500 евра пензија. Како да ви помогнеме кога вие имате повеќе пари, а ние имаме помалку?
Yes.
Како таа европска солидарност да се...
It's not only Estonia. Listen, the money is coming from 19 countries. Mm-hmm. Some of this money is coming directly. For instance, Spain is lend money directly to Greece, not through any mechanism, directly. Portugal, the same. Germany, the same. They lend the money directly. We are talking 30, 40 billion each country, you know. But it is ridiculous that of these 19 countries, 7 countries are much poorer than Greece. Slovakia Estonia, Latvia.
A tije treba da I pomagaju.
And they are helping Greece. Actually, each citizen of each of these countries is giving Greece 450 euros a month, in effect. This is completely crazy. The average pension in Greece is still 40% higher than the average pension in these poorer group of countries. Mm-hmm. In Greece, you can retire when you are 53. Age of pension is 53 in many professions. Now they put it up a little, so now it's 57, but was until now 53. And 57 is too low. In these countries, in Estonia, Latvia, it is 67. So they have to work extra 10 years to help the Greeks to go on pension when they are 57.
Мислите дека тој систем ќе се одржи, дека ќе функционира и
натаму? No, it's completely crazy. No. It's not reasonable to demand from these countries to give money to Greece, unless Greece agrees to substantial change in culture of the country. It's not only economic problem. Is to remove political parties from the economy, is to cut the government by half, is to cut pension to rich people. Do you know that the pension, if you are in Greece and you have apartment and so on and so on, and you have €1 million in the bank, €1 million cash in the bank, you are still getting pension. Your pension comes untouched, you are still getting it. It is called ECAS. This is crazy system, you know. So the Greeks must cut the pensions to the people with more than, let's say, 100, 150,000 euros cash in the bank. Not to delete, to cut.
Која е вашата прогноза во рамките на Европската Унија овие нелогичности? Ќе бидат наскоро средени? Ќе преземе некоја мерка? Некој во Европскиот парламент ќе се побуни? Во Европскиот совет?
Euro was badly designed. You cannot take poor countries, rich countries, countries with a lot of export, countries with no export, countries with this mentality, a little not, you know, productive, and country like Germany where every worker is producing like 100,000 euros a year. You can't take all these totally different countries, put them together in one currency. You don't do that. It is a big mistake. Sooner or later, the weak members, the poor members, will drag down, will make a house in the project. The right way to do it is for a group of rich countries to establish a currency. Exactly. And then this currency is slowly, once every 10 years, once every 20 years, to take another member. Slowly. Not like that. 19 members in 5 years. You know, it was totally... Look at the United States. The United States has a currency called US dollar. It is the currency of 50 states. It's exactly like EU, you know, 50 states. But United States didn't start like this. United States started with 13 states. These states were rich. All of them were very rich. Massachusetts, you know, New York. These were rich states. They established a currency for themselves. Slowly. It took 150 years. The last state was Hawaii. That was in 1950-something. 150 years. Slowly. They took another member, they built the currency over 150 years. You can't immediately declare currency and put Greece and Germany in the same club. They don't belong in the same club. So the problem is with the design of the euro. Mm-hmm. And it is fundamental. The euro must change. Not Greece.
Имате ли рецепт како да се промени?
The euro must not be a currency. It must be what we call a currency peg. Mm-hmm. Currency peg means that any country can use euros, no limitation. Montenegro is using euros, Kosovo is using euros, you know, any country. Tomorrow Macedonia can say we are using euros. Any country can use euros, but it's their responsibility. They manage the situation. They know best. They know tomorrow maybe euro is not good for me. I go out, I go in. This is called currency peg. Except small group of 7, 8, 10 countries, Scandinavia, Germany, maybe France, and so on. This group of countries, they have the euro as currency. Mm-hmm. Example, perfect example, is US dollar. US dollar is used in the United States as a currency, but is used in another 23 countries as a currency peg. The United States is not responsible. They want to use dollars.
Your problem.
Your problem. Use.
Vaknin, pri kraju smo na ovaj razgovor, dosta je dinamičan i interesan. Me interesira jedno ovakvo prašanje. Вие како аналитичар сте познат дека сте и добар прогнозер. Се сеќавам на еден ваш текст 98-ма, во дневник ми се чини го прочитав, дека ја најавивте кризата што изби 2008-ма, хипотекарната криза во Америка, па се префали во Европа. При крајот на овој разговор, имаме впечаток дека овие финансиски кризи се јавуваат циклично. Можете ли за гледачите на емисијава да ја чујат вашата прогноза? Колку ќе трае оваа криза? Кога и како ќе се појави следната и каде?
If the euro disappears tomorrow, I don't think there will be any serious economic consequences. Maybe 2-3 years there will be chaos because they will need to change currencies again, this, that, but there will not be fundamental economic consequences. On the contrary, by the way, I think it will be very good for Europe. So I don't regard the euro as a major crisis. But I think there are other threats. I have been saying for 6 years now that the economy of China is a pyramid scheme. Piramidalna schema. China is built on total falsificat. And it is, and I've been saying for 6 years, that one day will come that the economy of China will collapse completely. It will be exposed to be one big lie. I think these days are coming now. In Europe, so this is China. This is real economic crisis. This will have enormous tsunami impact on all the world. This is number one. Number two, in Europe, as long as they remain with the euro as a currency, there will continue to be instability in the banking system. Mm-hmm. Not economic instability, because the economy of Europe, all in all, is not in bad shape. Not brilliant shape, but not bad shape. But the banking system of Europe is a very dangerous situation. So, if the euro will continue as a currency, as it is now, the banks will pay the price, and soon. So I'm predicting a banking crisis in Europe, economic crisis in China, and huge effect on international trade, stock exchanges, and the prices of real estate. And I think all of this will happen this year. I believe all of this will happen this year. In other words, I believe this year China will collapse, and I believe this year we will see the collapse of one major European bank. One, I don't know which. Major European bank, which will drag with it other banks, unfortunately.
На крајот едно вакво прашање. Вие како Вакнин, сте човек кој патува, кој среќава луѓе. Кога последен пат сте биле во Грција?
2 months ago, 3 months ago. Why?
На каков пријем наидувате таму? Дали ве препознаваат, дали ве прашуваат за совет?
The Greeks?
Да.
No. I don't have any economic standing there. I don't know.
Одите инкогнито, некако.
Yes, I go incognito. Uh-huh. I want to feel the pulse of the. Yesterday I was contacted by some friend of the Prime Minister there for something, but it's an unusual event.
Добро. Има ли некое прашање што не го постави во ова интервју, а би сакале да го одговорите?
I just want to say that the problem is not that the Greek worker is lazy. Actually, the Greek worker is the hardest working labor in Europe. Mm-hmm. It's the hardest working. Works more hours than the German. But they are not productive. And the system in which they are working does not allow them to be productive because there is a lot of bureaucracy, a lot of political involvement. And in this sense, to some extent, we in Macedonia should look to the neighbor and learn many lessons. Because we are doing many of the same mistakes.
Сакате да кажете дека и на Македонија се заканува слична опасност?
Not anytime soon. But if we continue with some economic policies, and if we do not change mentality, and if we don't take the political parties out of the economy, which is the main thing, then yes, of course, we will end up the same.
Poštovani gledači, ovo beše intervjuto so našiot i vaš prijatelj Sem Vaknin.
Thank you.
Zbrojavme za ona što se slučiva v Grcija i njegovata posljedna poraka je da ги воочиме нивните грешки за да не се повторат кај нас. И благодарам на вниманието и доведување до следната прилика.